Well, that was a LoRa device fooling. And with Johan today from Zeus Network, we're going to show you how you can connect the LoRa infrastructure and devices to the cloud in order to detect the free fall of an object.
Right.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for watching the Internet of Things show. I'm Olivier, your host, and we have Johan with us from the Zeus Network. Johan, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Olivier.
I hear you're a bit jet-lagged.
I am. I woke up at 4 a.m. this morning.
So where are you coming from?
I'm from Amsterdam.
You're from Amsterdam?
Yes.
What are you doing there?
I live there, and we have our company there, the Things Network.
Okay.
So
the Things Network, we want to talk about what the Things Network is about and what LoRa is about. So tell me first about LoRa. What is LoRa?
So LoRa is a modulation to get information through the air over very long range using very little power.
Very little, as in way less than Wi-Fi, for example.
Yes, yes.
Less than 5G.
It's less than 5G. It's like for like 25 milliwatts.
Okay.
So it's you can actually run sensors for a few years.
Okay.
On a battery.
On a battery. On a regular like AAA battery.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's pretty interesting for IoT scenarios, right? Because you can have these tiny sensors that are actually in the dirt or somewhere, cheap ones, and they're there forever, and they're in remote locations. And now you can connect them, right? So do we see use cases today? Do you have customers working you're working with that actually have actual use cases for that?
Yeah, so we have two types of use cases. So already existing IoT deployments where they use currently Wi-Fi or Bluetooth.
Okay.
And then they switch to LoRa because they don't need the throughput, they don't need that much bandwidth, but they just like the battery life more. But there's also a whole class of new use cases that were not possible before. And that is now possible with LoRa.
Awesome. A little word about, we'll talk about the gizmos that we have here and solution and how it works and the Things Network as well. But before getting into there, the common question about IoT scenarios, especially when you start connecting things that were not connected, is security. So is LoRa a network that you can rely on from the security perspective and have devices authenticate themselves and really have a way to control who's connecting and who's sending data?
Yes, absolutely. Security is really at the heart of the LoRaWAN protocol.
Mm-hmm.
So devices need to authenticate with a network, otherwise there is no session.
Okay.
So network devices join a network,
okay.
and you can actually choose which network you want to join after you you created or manufactured the device.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, makes sense. And so now this protocol is not IP based. You're not actually doing TCP/IP and having a full stack on top, right? So you have to go through a gateway.
Yeah, you have to go through a gateway.
Okay.
So this is one of our indoor gateways. So this is a very cheap device, $69.
Okay.
And you can plug it in your power outlet and it provides coverage for the entire building typically, or a few floors. Sure. So for big offices, you can cover three floors with a single gateway like this.
Okay.
And it has a Wi-Fi backhaul because these gateways do need an internet connection.
Okay. Yeah.
And they provide, they listen to LoRa. Packets that are sent by devices like this.
Okay, so straightforward. So LoRa packets here, and then this into the cloud or a server, which is the backend, right?
Yes, exactly. And so this is typically just a forwarder. So there's no logic on the gateway other than just listening for packets and sending them to the cloud.
Okay.
But you can run, so the gateways are connected to a network server, and a network server does all the network layer logic of identifying the device, decoding the packets, doing all kind of MAC layer stuff that you would otherwise see in the internet protocol. But as you said, there is no internet in these things.
Yeah.
So that is what the network server is for. But you can run the network server in the cloud, but you can also run it on premises, for example.
Okay, interesting. Yeah. So you can build your own private LoRa network with these on-premise services, servers and so on.
Right? Yeah.
So all of that requires software. Right, and this is where the Things Network and the Things Industries, which is the company you're working with, and you created, co-founded, and entered into play. So tell me a bit about the Things Network and the Things Industries.
So the Things Network started about 4 years ago, more of as an experiment to build a community-driven LoRaWAN network, a global network. And we basically covered the city of Amsterdam with 10 gateways in 6 weeks. And it was kind of a recipe for the rest of the world to start building one big community network.
Okay.
And that went really fast. So within a few months, we had hundreds of gateways connected. And then we got a lot of demand also for private networks, for SLA, for custom solutions and integrations and so forth. So we decided to start a company next to it, The Things Industries. And that is where we do private networks, commercial networks, and we still contribute a lot to the open source community. Okay. So the community network today is around 8,500 gateways in size. And that makes it the biggest global LoRaWAN network. And we have a lot of private customers ranging in different industries like agriculture, logistics, smart buildings, maritime.
Okay. Yeah. So we'll talk about a national scenario, right? Johan, like, show me what you have. Tell me what is it that we have here. We have a gateway and we have a node. What are you going to show?
Yeah, so I have a gateway here. This is just a power connection. So I use this for development a lot. Okay. This is just a gateway. And this is connected to, over Wi-Fi to a network server that I'm running in the cloud. And this is our generic node. This is our new device that we build ourselves in the Things network. And it's used for all, can be used for all kinds of use cases. So it has 9 sensors, and you can think of around 20, 30 different use cases. So in this case, I put a small application on it to detect free fall. So you can attach this, for example, to something, a valuable asset. And when it falls, like cargo or something, you can get notified for that.
So you can code for that.
Yeah.
What are you using for that?
Yeah. So this is using embedded OS, but you can also because it's just an ARM processor, M0. So it's really a microcontroller unit, and it has an AA battery here in the back.
Yeah.
It's super low power.
Yeah.
But you can actually run all kinds of applications on this, and you can also remotely update the firmware.
And this is enterprise grade, right? This is not like kind of a funky makers playing device. This is actual.
This is made for volume.
Yeah. If you want to track your containers, if you want to track like real enterprise scenarios, you can actually use that node.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you code it now, it will detect free fall.
Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. And you have a solution right now here.
Yeah. So here we go.
Boom, free fall.
Free fall.
And what's happening?
Oh, and you see it's here. So and that's how you can configure. So this is connected already to IoT Central.
Okay.
So we build integrations with different IoT platforms. So we publish information through IoT Hub or IoT Central, so it can be analyzed further there.
Yeah.
So we really focus on the network layer.
Like it. So basically, you're providing, as a Things network, everything from the hardware all the way up to having your data flowing into the cloud. And from here on, actually, you have cloud services like Azure IoT, IoT Central, and others that will take for analytics, for visualization, interaction with line of business applications, and so forth.
Yeah, but what's good to mention is that so even though we do build end devices, we do build gateways, we do build a network server, but everything is standardized. So we use standard interfaces, so we use LoRaWAN. So we also support all kinds of other gateways built by other industry partners.
Okay.
So this one is really good for indoor use cases, but if you want to deploy gateways on towers, for example, you use industrial gateways, which we also work with.
And actually, you have a catalog of all these devices, right?
Yeah. Exactly. That was what I wanted to show next. So we have the marketplace on our website, thethingsnetwork.org.
Okay.
And here you find a lot of different devices, and we also segmented them already to verticals. So here you see, for example, devices you can use in agriculture, smart buildings, smart metering, logistics and tracking, and so you can get started really quick.
Okay.
So this is
One last question about, so what does it take to connect one of these devices? We're saying that we need to authenticate the device in the server. So what does it take as a user to make that happen?
Yeah. So we're going to make that really easy. That was actually kind of a pain point in LoRaWAN. In the last few years. So what we're doing, we're adding a QR code on the device, which is going to be a standard LoRaWAN QR code. So all the LoRa ecosystem is going to use that format.
Awesome.
And you'll be able to scan it with your phone and onboard the device directly in a network server. And this, again, can be a network server operated by us. It can be operated by you, yourself, in the cloud, in Azure.
Yeah.
Or you take the open source distribution or run it on a Raspberry Pi.
Got it.
It's super versatile.
That's awesome. I can definitely see the scenario of the frontline worker who is actually deploying a new set of devices and sensors, and just that you bloom, bloom, blip, and then just connects, right?
Right, yeah.
I love it.
That's awesome. The idea.
So you guys have an event coming up. So you have the Things Conference. It's going to be in January.
Yes, January 3rd and 31st in Amsterdam. And it's going to be the biggest LoRaWAN event ever.
Okay.
We're expecting 2,000 people. Yeah. Last year we had 1,200 people, I think. And it's growing year on year. It's going to be the third edition. We're going to do a lot of announcements there. We have a lot of industry partners.
Something makes me say or think that Microsoft will be down there as well.
I bet you will be there again. Yeah.
I hope it's not a void promise, but we'll see. Yeah. No, we'll be there for sure. Thanks, Johan, for sharing all of that. Yeah. If you guys want to learn more about the Things Network, you can go to aka.ms/IoTshow/thethingsnetwork. Pretty straightforward, just there. Johan, thanks for making the trip all the way here to Redmond. Hope to see you soon.
Sure, thank you.
Thanks for watching the IoT Show, and see you soon.
See ya.